So this is the first adventure I have with Randonautica, and it led me to this tree. We need to give it a name. Okay, so this is very weird. I am currently on my second Randonaut trip, and there is a street called Plantation Road. In order to get to my destination, I have to go down this one. And the name Plantation is like deja vu, and I'll explain in a minute why. A cement truck and some weird machine. I don't know what on earth it is. It is extremely slow. And I'm just really, and the school bus is also coming, great. I'm just to see what on earth am I being led to? And now there's a car behind me. Great, I'm causing traffic, not good. Semi-circle, and for some reason, I saw that red car. There's a red car behind me. And I'm not sure, but that's what this, it led me to this, a construction. And I have a red car that has been pretty much, I don't know if it got lost or if it's the same one. From where did it go? I don't even see it anymore. That's very weird. It led me to a construction site. I finally made it safe back to the house, and I'm about to explain what I found interesting about the synchronicity I have had with Randonautica. So on the first trip I did on Randonautica, it took me to a parking spot in front of a petroleum company with the word plantation on it. And then today I make my second trip on Randonautica, and it takes me to a destination where I have to drive on a road called Plantation Road. On the first trip, I chose Quantum Random, and then today I chose, I believe you're supposed to say Pseudo Random. So essentially, both trips that I have made so far on Randonautica have been random by using the quantum machine they claim they have that picks the coordinates. On the first trip that I ever made, I was extremely excited and completely open to just go wherever it was that the universe was going to take me. And that's how I ended up in that particular plaza with the petroleum company that had a name Plantation. The whole plaza was like closed down, but there were really expensive cars parked in random spots. We're talking like GT, Mercedes, BMWs, last model trucks, stuff like that. And then today, what a coincidence. Which I don't believe it was a coincidence, because I prayed to my spiritual squad before clicking the button to get a location. So I know I was meant to be there. I find it extremely interesting how in just two trips that I clicked on random, I already created a synchronicity in my tunnel of reality. Now, I will continue to pray every time that I use the app Randonautica, because I am aware of the darker things that exist in this simulation that we currently live in, and I don't want that. Randonautica sent me to a very interesting place that I'll explain later. But for some reason, I was being called out to this section of the park, and look what I found. Purple flower. Monarch butterfly is literally flying across in front of me. What? Oh my gosh. What? Oh my goodness. I cannot believe it. Only
y'all, I can't believe it. There's a sea turtle.
That was a sea turtle. In a dog pool. Oh my goodness. Just like my dog. Not even joking.
Okay. gotta get off the window. How do I pick you up? Oh my gosh, no! Come on! No! I have arrived to Randonautica trip number 4, and it led me to this place. Let's see if I can find
it. What even is this?
I know that down there, there's some kind of river, but I didn't really find anything here. Interesting place though. Except for that big, I don't know if it's a boulder. Just a big pile of sand. It's very weird. Maybe I can find something crossing this street. Maybe I'll find something here.
This is the only thing I found, a tomato. A tomato.
Interesting.
Quadruple 7. I cannot make up the amount of synchronicities I have seen on this trip. It's ridiculous.
So this is Randonautica trip number 6. I wanted to meet true Odin today, and then this started to happen, but that's not going to stop me from this mission. We will see where I end up.
It took me to this house. Now I'm gonna have to research the meaning behind those numbers. I'm not really interested in walking into someone's home. There's no one really there, and it's raining. Plus, there's neighbors who are staring at me already.
I find it interesting. That's what old people do once they're retired. They just stalk on their neighbors.
I did another Randonautica to find Odin, and again, I've been brought to purple flowers. Not a coincidence.
Found the ball
and a playground, so I'm assuming this belongs to one of the kids in there.
Let's give it back. They must miss it. There we go. I'm glad I have my boots on today. It is not easy going through this. Well, it's a peaceful place. I'm glad I was able to help some kids, but I still have a lot of questions.
There.
This is very interesting. There is a black cat right in front of me. That is the second black cat I see today. There's been other things I have noticed when I've been asked to be taken to Odin. I have seen synchronicities that I'll explain later.
I just wanted to share something really quick that I have noticed about my trips on Randonautica. When I say I want to be taken to Odin, I have also seen two pentagrams. I have seen an old man hiking with a really, really long beard that was pretty much all the way down to his belly button. Then today I see two black cats and purple flowers again. And I saw 555, 777, 999, and the synchronicities won't stop. And then I got sad because I got a message on my phone saying that I'm running out of data, that I only have 10% left. So that means there's no more Randonautica for the rest of the month of April, which it makes me sad. I still have no idea why I am constantly being led to the word plantation, and I still haven't gotten all of my answers for being led to Odin. Obviously, these are questions and intentions that will not be answered until May, but I want to thank all of you for spending your time watching my trips, which I have enjoyed a lot. And I will continue to do Randonautica as long as the app exists. I recommend for you to give Randonautica an attempt and try to find the magic in life again. Pray before you get a generated point, of course. Do your best to sit down first and create a list of all the things you would like to find or questions you want answered. But it's best to think before you act. Here we have this amazing tool that could probably even help us find missing children. If that's one of the missions you want to do, make sure you go in a group and you have some kind of protection. There's enough evil in this world. Therefore, I don't agree with people constantly using Randonautica to manifest evil, fear, murder. People don't realize that they could easily be taken to a place where those types of intentions are about to take place, and they don't realize that they themselves could be the victim to the intention they are manifesting through that app. Something extremely dumb to do. You have people using the app with the intent to find death. Those people are no different from that YouTuber that found a dead body in Japan in that suicide forest they have. You are no different from him, yet the whole world was judging him for doing such thing, and yet you have people doing the same with here. I am not defending him at all. I never found it funny what he did. I don't even know his name. I forgot his name. I'm sure someone in the comments section is going to name him. He's extremely popular on YouTube still after that incident. So, because this is an app first of its kind, use Randonautica for something good. Make your life better. At least.